as...
Hey guys, this is Mitko, the allergic beekeeper.
And I'm Jen, just being myself.
Honey crystallization is a natural process that happens to all types of honey, and it's a great indicator that shows that the honey is unfiltered, natural, and raw.
Honey is composed of two naturally occurring sugars, fructose and glucose. Fructose is responsible for the sweet taste, and it's also more water-soluble, while sucrose is less water-soluble and is the one responsible for forming the crystals. The ratio of fructose to glucose really depends on the flower nectar. It varies across every single type of honey. So for example, acacia honey, which has a very low glucose content, can take sometimes up to 2 to 3 years to even start forming crystals.
Versus the canola or the sunflower honey, which crystallizes much faster and can start forming crystals even in the honeycomb.
Pure honey never spoils, so you never need to put it in the fridge. In fact, honey will crystallize faster if it's below 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 10 degrees Celsius. So if you like to keep your honey liquid longer, you want to store it at room temperature.
If you like your honey liquid, you can always decrystallize it, but it is very important on what temperature. To keep all the valuable nutrients in the honey, it is recommended to decrystallize it at temperatures not higher than 104 Fahrenheit or 40 Celsius.
But the high glucose honeys, like sunflower or canola, they can recrystallize again in only a week or two.
It must be in their nature.
Yeah. Our honey is raw and unfiltered, which keeps all the healthy enzymes, minerals, vitamins, nutrients, and pollens intact.
Having high pollen count in the honey is very good because it's a great source of vitamins and proteins, but it also acts as a starting point for the crystals to grow. So the higher the pollen count is, the faster the honey is going to crystallize.
The faster a honey crystallizes, the finer the crystal texture will be. That's why a lot of people like to use canola honey for creamed honey, which spreads kind of like peanut butter. Others like really big crystals, like grains of sand, because it's like rock candy, and the flavor is way more concentrated.
We like to use crystallized honey for our flavored honeys, because it keeps the spices, like ginger or turmeric, more evenly distributed.
Don't worry when you see a separation between crystallized honey and liquid honey. Glucose crystals are naturally pure white, and due to their density, they go to the bottom of the jar, while you have the darker liquid honey on top. When you see that, you're actually in luck because you can have your honey both ways. And sometimes you might see a layer of pure white crystallized honey on top, which is honey in its purely decrystallized form.
Despite that the honey doesn't expire, the food regulations require us to put expiration date on the honey.
So when you're shopping at the grocery store and you see on the label that maybe it's been sitting on the shelf for a year or two and there's no signs of crystallization at all, I would be a little bit suspicious that maybe all the pollen's been filtered out or the honey has been overheated, which strips it of its natural health benefits.
So now you know everything about crystallized honey.
Except, how do you say crystallized honey in Bulgarian?
Kristalliziran met.
Ah. Crystallization met. We learned met before. Stay tuned for our next episode where we'll bring you with us to a fireside chat in our living room about our entire journey thus far with our honey company.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell so you get notifications when we post new videos, and also like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram.
And we want to know, do you prefer your honey runny or crystallized, and why?
See you next time.
And always remember to be yourself.
Buzz.